Woke up this morning, looking right for my shoe. Look like I got them old, oh, walking blues for now. Woke up this morning, looking around for my shoe. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Cadillac Hotel. Okay, Leroy and Kathy grew something really, really nice here for us, didn't they? They really, really did. They gave us a wonderful place to be, live, experience, and perform. My name is Mr. Jeffrey. I'm the host and tour guide for this afternoon on our trek. I'm also the director of San Francisco Recovery Theater. Some of you may know what we do. We're blasting hard from ground zero. We deal with all issues. We take people as they are. We make sure that you have an opportunity to voice your feeling and emotion, and we'll give you talent and skill set to do that, whether it be music, whether it be theater, poetry, and if you just can swing a hammer and a nail, okay? So keep your eyes open, that's what Recovery Theater is about, and fortunately we are based here at Ground Zero. I'm very fortunate to have family and friends. My good friend, Spencer Bearfield, flew all the way from Detroit, Michigan to be here and help support San Francisco Recovery Theater and the Green Mobile Kitchen, because what's good theater without a good meal, all right? So we want to give Spencer acknowledgement and support for being here. He's a premier virtuoso on the strings. We also have another young man who I've known my entire life. He happens to be my brother, David Allen Greer, who also has decided to lend his support to this effort. And I want to show my appreciation for him for being here and just letting us all know that this is a village, okay? Then, of course, we've got musicians that keep things rolling. We've got Dave Austin on piano. Yeah. Chuck Bennett on bass. Bob Blankenship on drums. And my musical performers will be introduced as they come forward. But you know what? Why don't we all take a brief walk? You know, they've been giving tenderloin tours recently, you know, a lot of these tenderloin tours, so people can have an opportunity to see what it's like out here on the streets. And I've written a little piece. I'm still working on it, and I want to command it to memory, but I want you to walk with me. We're gonna go back in time. That's why I'm wearing this hat, okay? Come with me. We're gonna go back to a time where music was king and the Tenderloin ran things. And we were where artists all wanted to be. This is the Artist Enclave. It's a place that we all know. In the pre-dawn hours, deep in the armpit of San Francisco's Tenderloin District, the hustle and bustle of the night creatures can be heard as they scurry about in hopes of finding shelter before the sun catches them unexposed. As we focus in on the corner of Turk and Hyde, previous location of the famed Black Hawk, the emptiness of the space screams of a need to be occupied as the fenced-in area now houses a parking lot in the heart of one of the most densely populated neighborhoods in San Francisco. Now, there are a number of stories about how the Tenderloin got its name. Some people say it was the easiest beat for a policeman to be on. Graft, you know, a lot of payoffs. Other people say it resembles the soft inner thighs of a local prostitute, the Tenderloin. Whichever version you choose to pick, the name stuck. The Tenderloin, and we wear it proudly. Now the Tenderloin borders the Mission Street and is sheltered by Knob Hill. Since 1898, all the buildings in the neighborhood were destroyed, almost, by the 1906 earthquake. The back fires were all set by firefighters to contain the devastation. The Tenderloin was immediately rebuilt, though, with hotels reopening by 1907, including the famous Cadillac Hotel. Well, I'm gonna skip forward, because the most important fact is that we are here. And you know the Tenderloin is home of alternate sexualities. Everybody and anybody can live in the Tenderloin, because we're all here together. Now it is in this setting that we find two past middle-aged black men arguing. One looks as if he's been waiting on the bus to take him to a manual labor job, and he's carrying a lunchbox that must be 25 years old. The other looks as though he may be homeless, although his command of the English language far exceeds his look. They carry on and they argue back and forth and back and forth. And if you're an artist, you sacrifice all. Well, if you're an artist, you get a job and you make sure you can do your art. Sacrifice everything, be homeless, be an artist. Get a job, do what you can, be an artist. The yin and yang of survival. But the one thing about these two, they always seem to come together about one subject. It's called the Black Hawk Jazz Club. And when they talk about this, they talk about that special woman that they all seem to have an affinity for. And we're gonna have Eric Ward come up and tell you about this woman. Put your hands together for Mr. Eric Ward.
Here we go. Most likely. Oh, that's so cool. Hello. Let me tell you about this special girl. Oh, yes. I can see her now. They say Ruby, you're like a dream. You're not quite what you seem. Though my heart may break when I awake, let it be so. I only know, Ruby, it's you. You know, they say, Ruby, you're like a song. You don't know you're right from your wrong. And in your eyes, I see heartaches for me. Right from the start, who stole my heart? Ruby, it's you. You know, darling, I hear your voice, and I must run to you. I simply have no choice. Oh, darling, what else could I do? They say, Ruby, you're like a flame. into my life. You came, and though I should be worse, still I don't care. Let it be so. I only know Ruby. Oh, Ruby. Oh, Ruby. It's you.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Eric Ward. Boy is smooth, isn't he? Well, listen, we're going to make sure we get everybody up here because you know what? We are at the Black Hawk, right? We're at the Black Hawk. Ladies and gentlemen, we got another man known as the Bass of the Bay, a virtuoso himself. Put your hands together for Mr. Ben Bacow.
Good afternoon. All right, I'm gonna adjust this up a little bit if I can. Hey, how are you, my friend? We've been having some really wonderful experiences here the last couple of nights, playing Night at the Black Hawk. I don't wanna hit my friend back there, Mr. Chuck Bennett, behind me. How's everybody? Hey! Over there and over here and everybody. My name is Ben, and I think no matter where you go, you know the music of the Black Hawk and the music of our community all began in the church. I want to take you out of church, or the way church used to be when I was growing up. Come on, give me that clap. As I tell you about us, as a people, and why we're here today. To see clear through despair, the way we've always done, to be burdened with care.
the darkness to grow. With deep faith in the dark, and to manage to hold.
Ladies and gentlemen, Ben Bacow. Seems like a right time to pass the plate, don't you think?
Yeah,
we're gonna have to work that out, Ben, you know. Ladies and gentlemen, I wanna thank each and every one of you for being here. And once again, we are SF Recovery Theater in collaboration with From the Garden to the Table. And we've got a truck outside. We're gonna feed you after the show. Good food, by the way, for the Green Mobile Health Education Kitchen. But none of this could happen without you. Just know that, none of it. With that, I think we've gone to church, right? And we found out what happened on the corner of the Black Hawk. I think we went from church to the Delta Blues. Is that not correct? Is that how the sequence went? Something like that? All right. I think we ought to have Dag come on up here and do a little piece that he's crafted. And let's go to Blues Town, shall we? So put your hands together, Mr. David Allen Greer.
All right, first of all, my name's David Allen Greer. I wanna say how happy I am to be here amongst you all today. Beautiful people of Tenderloin. Saturday afternoon, and Spencer Bearfield, he doesn't know, you know, when I was a kid growing up in Detroit, he had a band. I'm sure you've heard of it, sir, the Seven Sounds. And he and my big brother, they used to play, and we looked up to him, man. They were the big boys, you know, doing real music, so I'm so happy that he's here today. Rest of these beautiful musicians letting me noodle around a little bit. We're gonna do a little thing that Robert Johnson recorded. A lot of people recorded, but Muddy Waters is my man. He's a favorite version, Walking Blues. Woke up this morning, looking around for my shoe. Look like I got them old. Oh, walking blues for now. This morning, look around for my shoes. Look like I got them all. Oh, walking blues. Some say don't worry. Worst home feeling, man, I most ever had. This is the Queen of Spades, little Queen of Spades. Oh, I'm pulling up my pants, I left my belt in Los Angeles, I apologize. I'm not perfect. So this is me and the bass player, we're gonna do something. Again, it's Robert Johnson, it's my hero. Robert Johnson, sir, Robert Johnson. All right, here we go, little Queen of Spades. Men just won't let her be. She's a little queen of spades, and the men just won't let her be. Every time she makes a spread, cold chills run all over me. Gambling woman, it is the last thing that I do. Gonna get me, gambling woman, it is the last thing that I do. A man don't need a woman, he gotta give all his money to. And I believe she been you next up. She got a way of trembling down. Believe it's most too tough.
Come on, Spencer. Nice. I like that phrase. Let's turn all this money green. Don't you think? Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, it's time for some local talent before we get to the other big boys. I want you to put your hands together for my stage manager, Pamela Coates. You know her quite well. It's going to follow in the sequence of chronological order of music. Pam.
Hi, how you doing? So, while we have the Black Hawk on the West Coast, there was a place called the Cotton Club on the East Coast. And there were two riders, particularly Harold Mercer and, no, Johnny Mercer and Harold Arlen, who wrote a lot of songs. This is one of them. My mama just told me when I was in pigtails. My mama just told me, she said, huh, a man's gonna sweet talk and give you the big eye. But when the sweet talk is done, a man is a two-faced, a worrisome thing who leaves you to sing the blues in the night. Now the rains are falling, hear the rain are calling. Ooh-wee. My mama done told me, hear its lonesome whistle blowing across the trestle. My mama done told me, a hooey, a hooey, a clickety clack come echoing back the blues in the night. The evening breeze will find the trees, the crying and the moon will hide its light. When you get the blues in the night, and take my word, the mockingbird will sing his saddest song. He knows things are wrong and he's right. Ooh, from Natchez to Mobile, from Memphis to St. Joe, wherever the four winds blow. I've been in some big towns, and I've heard me some big talk, but there is one thing I know. A man is a two-faced, a worrisome thing who'll leave you to sing the blues in the night. There's blues in the night. Thank you. Thank you. Mr. Dave Austin, Mr. Chuck Bennett, Mr. Bob Blankenship. Thank you. And Mr. Jeffrey Grimm.
Ladies and gentlemen, Pamela Coates. You gotta have your homegrown, you know? You got to have your homegrown. Well, we're marching through. We're trying to keep everybody in tune. Let's see, we haven't lost too many folks. Is the food almost ready, Smith? Yep. Oh, he's shaking his head. Gotta wait about another 30 minutes. That's okay. You know what? It's a very sunny day, don't you think? It's one of those rare sunny days in San Francisco. And I think we need none other than San Francisco Recovery Theater's own. Where is he? They call him Sweet Black from way back. What's his name? What? Ladies and gentlemen, I want you to put your hands together for Mr. Vernon Medeiros, and he's gonna give you a very, very sunny day.
Thank you. How y'all doing today? How y'all back there? Good to see everybody. We got a nice sunshiny day outside and in here full of sunshiny smiles. Yes, I want to see all the smiles on your faces. Let me see some sunshine smiles. Come on now. Come on now. Sunny. Sunshine bouquet, sunny, thank you for the love you brought my way. And I love you. And I love you. I love you, Sonny. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Woo! Sweet Black from way back. Vernon Medeiros. Vernon Medeiros. Well, ladies and gentlemen, I was about to give up on one of our singers, but she braved through trials and tribulations, fought her way back much like many of us do. Isn't that true? Sometimes we're down, but we make our way back. It's hot, it's cold, she's up, she's down, she can't breathe, she's trying to catch her breath. But ladies and gentlemen, I want you to put your hands together for one of San Francisco's best kept secrets. Miss Cherie Taylor!
I need a second, I gotta breathe. Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Isn't it a beautiful day today? Yes. Well, since it's summertime, I'm gonna give you a little summertime. Summertime, and the living is easy. Fish are jumping, and the cotton is high. Your daddy's rich, and your mama's good looking. So hush, little baby, don't you cry. Summertime, and the living is easy, yeah. Fish are jumping, and don't you know the cotton is high. Your daddy's rich, and your mama's good looking, yeah, yeah, she is. Baby, don't you cry. One of these mornings, you're gonna rise up. You're gonna rise up singing. And you'll spread your little wings, and you'll take to the sky. Gonna harm you, 'cause your mommy and your daddy is standing by. Yeah, take it away. Little wings, and you'll take to the sky.
sister, don't you cry.
See you, baby, that's all. Ladies and gentlemen, Cherie Taylor flew all the way in from Alabama. Anyway, before we let my partner take us on out, where's that young lady that was hollering and screaming? Well, that's our people. Just let it happen. Ladies and gentlemen, before we get to Spencer, I just feel like I gotta do a cross cut real quick because one of my father's favorite songs was a tribute to Paul Robeson. And there's nobody better able to do the old man River than Ben McCoe. Yeah.
That old man River, you must know something, but don't say nothing. He keeps on rolling, just keeps rolling along. He don't plant taters, he don't plant cotton, and them that plant them are soon forgotten. Yet old man River, he just keeps rolling along. You and me, we sweat and strain, bodies all aching and racked with pain. Tote that bar, lift that bale, you get a little drunk and you land in jail. Sick of trying, I'm tired of living, yet scared of dying. Yet old man River, he just keeps rolling along. You and me, we sweat. Bodies all aching and racked with pain. Tote that barge and lift that bale. You get a little drunk and you land in jail. Life gets tired, sick of trying, tired of living, yet scared of dying. Yet old man River, he just keeps rolling on. Thank you. Thank you.
I ain't gonna stop, I'm just getting started. Ladies and gentlemen, the bass of the Bay, Ben Bacow. Come on now. Woo, welcome to the Tenderloin, that's how we do it. That's what's here, that's what's here. In case anybody needed to know. Well, ladies and gentlemen, at this part of the show, I'm gonna turn it over to what the Black Hawk was about, although all of this was what the Black Hawk was really about, everything you've seen so far. But the Black Hawk was a jazz club. It was a musician's place. It was the place to be. When musicians would come down from playing those high tone gigs up on the hill, they'd come to the Black Hawk because then they could cut loose and do their thing. Let the hair down. And you know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna get out the way and let my boy Spencer do his thing, okay? So put your hands together for Spencer Bearfield.
Thank you.
Run the clock out, Spence. It's on you.
Y'all all know about the blues, huh? Good one, bad one, old one, new one. No matter what color you are, no matter what corner of the planet you're from, everybody knows a little bit of something about the blues. Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, Spencer Bearfield. David Allen Greer. Yeah. Ben Bacow. Yeah. Eric Ward. Yeah. Pamela Coates. Yeah. Cherie Taylor. Yeah. Who'd I leave out? Yeah. Vernon Madera, sweet black from way back. And of course, our band, Dave Austin, Chuck Bennett, Bob Blankenship, and my name is Mr. Jeffrey, your host with the most. Why don't you go home and tell somebody what happened when the circus came to town, okay? You let them know what's happening here, and when you hear the names, you'll know what we're doing, because we're not leaving, we're just passing through. We'll be back. Thank you, Kathy. SF Recovery Theater, from the garden to the table, and everybody that's associated to this with this operation. I want to thank each and every one of you.
That old man river, you must know something, but don't say nothing. He keeps on rolling, just keeps rolling along.
As we focus in on the corner of Turk and Hyde, previous location of the famed Black Hawk, the emptiness of the space screams of a need to be occupied, as the fenced-in area now houses a parking lot in the heart of one of the most densely populated neighborhoods in San Francisco. Now, there are a number of stories about how the Tenderloin got its name. Some people say it was the easiest beat for a policeman to be on. Graft, you know, a lot of payoffs. Other people say it resembles the song.
Now let's say I'm the king, and Fair Brown, you is my queen. They say I am the king, baby, but Fair Brown, you is my queen. Let's turn all this money green.